Nnenna, Elendu, Ukeje, member representing Benda Federal Constituency, Mr. Speaker, sir, and from Abia State. Mr. Speaker, I've listened to the contributions on the floor, and let me also lend my voice to what the Honourable Princess has said, that these are two motions. Mr. Speaker, sir, this motion speaks to the functions of Nigerian embassies and embassies around the world. We have embassies that carry out the core functions as envoys of a country, which would have to do with trade, which would have to do with friendly nations, which will have to do with intelligence and security, which will have to do with bilateral and multilateral agreements, which will have to do with procurement processes and the oversight of laws, appropriations and policies, directions of Nigeria's foreign policy direction, as well as consular services. Mr. Speaker, sir, consular services would engage, of course, with treatment of Nigerians, and of course, at every mission, we have representatives of the people from the Ministry of Interior who have to do with issuance of passports, etc., etc., etc. Mr. Speaker, sir, this motion seeks to lump the functions of the Ministry of Interior with the functions and direction of Nigeria's foreign policy and treatment of her citizens abroad, as well as one of the functions, and that is one in four of the functions of every embassy, which is diaspora matters. Mr. Speaker, as I stand here to support that indeed our missions may have been found wanting, we have as a committee continued to ask the question that there be a one-line item that speaks to consular services. Mr. Speaker, everybody who has engaged in the budget defense recognizes that there is a template and a platform, and no ministry has a template that is individual to it. To that end, Mr. Speaker, sir, there are no appropriations for consular services under the present template that we have. Therefore, as a committee, we have consistently tried to create that intervention. And Mr. Speaker, we all know as members of parliament that you can only oversight what you appropriate. What do we appropriate in the Committee on Foreign Relations? We oversight appropriations, we oversight laws, and we oversight policies. These are firmly domiciled within the Committee on Foreign Relations. Of course, the issue of the issuance of passports is also domiciled within the Committee of Interior. Mr. Speaker, to that end, I shall be moving an amendment to this motion. Mr. Speaker, let me also remind this House that we have a Committee on Public Procurement that has to do with the processes of procurement. Therefore, my amendment that I shall be moving shall be that this motion, the motion on the appropriation processes of the procurement processes, be moved to the Committees on Foreign Relations as the Committee on Public Procurement, and the issue that has to do with consular services, Mr. Speaker, sir, of course, I do not see the confluence in this motion. Therefore, when Mr. Speaker from the chair calls for his amendments with the imprimatur, Mr. Speaker, sir, I shall be moving for that amendment. And until a time such as that, Mr. Speaker, sir, I shall rest my case. Thank you very much. Mr. Speaker, sir, in line of the body of the motion, I move that the matter be referred to the House Committees on Foreign Affairs and Public Procurement. I so move.